Hello friends and welcome back. This is Dr. Janardhan Pawar. I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, Academic Insights. Friends, as we are going through practice questions of business communication, so I welcome you all to my third video, which is made for practicing questions which are based on multiple choices. So please allow me to share my screen so that I can show you one more video of MCQ question. I hope my screen is visible. I welcome you all to my official YouTube channel, that is Academic Insights. And for this channel, I am sharing some academic videos related to your studies and your career and so on. So once again, I welcome. This is Dr. Janardhan Pawar. And I welcome you all, heartily welcome you all to my academic channel. So if you like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe my channel. Also press the bell icon so that you can get more videos in days to come. Also like my videos. If you like my videos, please don't forget to share my videos with your friends, relatives and colleagues. Also write your comment in chat box so that I can improve in days to come. So friends, today I'm here for third video of a multiple choice question based on topic number one and topic number two for your exam. So if you go through all these questions, definitely these questions will be useful for you guys to write your examination. So I'm starting with question number one. So question number one is, dash is the wordless form of communication which takes the form of postures, body language, facial expressions, eye contact, tension, breathing, and tones, etc. So what does it mean? So the options are verbal communication, garbage communication, informal communication, non-verbal communication. So though these are the options, we have to find one, we have to choose one option as a correct option, and the correct option is non-verbal communication. Friends, moving on to the next question. Dash means the position in which you hold your body when standing or sitting. So when we stand or when we sit and we fold our body in a particular manner, what it is called? The options are gestures, postures, paralanguage, proximity. And the correct option is postures. We call it postures. Now, the question number three, postures fall under dash communication, whether it is oral communication, visual communication, written communication, or spoken communication. And the correct option is written communication. Posture comes under the category of written communication, no doubt. Question number four, which of the following combination are examples of written communication? We have to find out the example of written communication here. Later than voicemail, reports and emails, circulars and voicemail, and the last one, all of the above. And the correct option is reports and emails. Question number five, examples of written communication is dash, later, email, report, all of the above. And the correct option is all of the above. Question number six, which of these has maximum reach, which can be reached at maximum level? And the options are writing, listening, speaking, reports. And the correct option is speaking. If we speak, that can be reached at maximum level. Question number seven, How is good technical writing achieved? How we can achieve good technical writing? The options are naturally, by practice, listening, speaking. And the correct option is by practice, we can achieve a skill of good technical writing. Question number eight, which of these parameters are not required to define style? So out of given parameters, which one is not required to define style? And the options are moral truth, compassion, gender, information. And the correct option is gender. Question number nine, which of these are to be avoided in any style of writing? Which can be avoided in any style of writing? The options are truth, clarity, compassion, dishonesty. And the correct option is dishonesty, can be avoided always. Question number 10, arriving ahead of time for a meeting is an example of what? And the options are feedback, body language, non-verbal communication, verbal communication. And the correct option is, it is called as body language. Question number 11. Wrong decoding means, for what we can call it a wrong decoding. And the options are badly worded message, message sent to wrong receiver, interpreted meaning is different from intended message. And the last one, message sent by wrong sender. And the correct option is interpreted meaning is different from intended message. So these are the options. Then which of the following indicates the correct consequence of the element of communication in the communication process? So these are, this one is a sequence of communication elements they have given. So out of those, you guys have to choose one correct option as which shows the correct sequence of elements. And the correct option is the last one, that is sender, message, channel, receiver, feedback. Question number 12, which of the following is are barriers of listening? What are the barriers of listening they are asking about? Sluggishness, premature evaluation, external distraction, all of the above. And the correct option is all of the above, all are correct. Question number 13, the following is our non-verbal communication. Out of this, which one is the part of non-verbal communication they are asking? Facial expressions, appearance, postures, and the last one, all of the above. And the correct answer is all of the above. Question number 14, communication is the task of imparting what? Training, information, knowledge, message. And the correct answer is message. Number 15, the whole concept of achieving success begins with how you dash. Option number 1, behave. Second, think. Third, work. D, all of the above. And the correct answer is all of the above. So if you want to get success, if you want to achieve success, you have to go for all. You have to behave properly, you have to think properly, you have to work properly. So answer is all of the above. Question number 16, as per Newman and Summer, communication is the exchange of what? Facts, opinion, emotions, and the option D, all of the above. And the correct option is all of the above. Question number 17, following are the most effective ways of communication. And the options are verbal, non-verbal, written, all of the above. And the correct option is all of the above. Question number 18, goals help us to what? And the options are communicate, success, work, motivate. And the correct option is success. If you want to get a success, there should be a goal. Our goals will help us to get success. Question number 19, the upward communication flows from. And the options are a subordinate to superior, a subordinate to subordinate, a superior to a superior to a subordinate. And the correct option is a subordinate to a superior. Question number 20, and this could be the last question. Which are the examples of written communication? And the options are letter, email, fax, all of the above. And the correct option of written communication, as far as example is concerned, is all of the above. So here we have seen the examples of written communication, and that was question number 920. I hope you guys have understood the questions with answers in a bright manner. So before going to take a break, I request you all, if you really like my videos, please don't forget to subscribe. Also press the bell icon so that we can have videos in days to come. Also like my videos, also share my videos with your friends and colleagues. And don't forget to write your comment in chat box so that I can improve my videos in days to come. Thank you very much. See you next video. Till then, take care and all the best for your exam. Thank you very much.